Right now, it is time to bring in Ruth Epstein from the Republican American. Ruth covers our area. You can find her stories in the paper or online, rep-am.com. Ladies and gentlemen, let's bring her in. Good morning, Ruth.
Good morning, Marshall. Hi, Jill.
You just don't want to be just the most innocent little bug in Marshall's. You just don't.
No, I'm staying out of his aim.
That's right. He's wrong place, wrong time. Anyway, so we got through a pretty busy weekend.
We got through a very busy weekend because it was a very busy weekend. Lots going on this time of year, and now it slows down. We were at the Rose Allgrand Art Show in Cornwall Friday night, which was, talk about being packed, it was packed. That is where they exhibit local artists. It's been 60 years since this show started, and it gets bigger and bigger each year. We were at the Habitat tag sale that you don't mention.
That's right.
And we were up at the triathlon on Saturday morning, bright and early, and I give those folks credit.
It was like 75 people.
It was more like 60, but okay. It was so interesting because I was trying to talk to folks, and everybody I talked to seemed to be 60 or over. And I mean, I could barely get up to get there in the morning, and they're out there in their bathing suits and ready to do the three, you know, it was half-mile swim around Mudge Pond, and at 8 o'clock in the morning, I can't imagine how warm it was, and then a 12-mile bike ride and a 4-mile run. And a guy from Lakeville, Kyle Halloran, was the winner in an unbelievable time. So Terry Lefferts was one of the gals running, and this was her 14th triathlon. Yeah. You've got to be impressed. Got to be impressed.
Amazing, amazing.
It is amazing for those of us who, you know, don't get out much. We were at a selectmen's meeting early in the week in Salisbury, and they are talking about, Jeremy Dakin came in very concerned about the Great Falls. People in that area have seen some pretty horrible things going on up there with parents throwing their kids in the water and people doing foolish things, and he asked if there couldn't be, you know, some maybe more signage, and the selectmen will be looking into that. That area is owned by First Light. And
I was going to say, First Light's the one that's going to have to come up and
come
do
up
something.
But the town can do maybe some more no parking signs, but as Curtis Rand, the first selectman, said, you know, it's expensive to have to monitor that place. So, but it's beautiful and deadly. That's all you can say about that, the falls.
It's one of those places. The Housatonic River itself is beautiful and deadly. Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter
whether it's flood stage or whether it's not flood stage.
You're right. It's a river.
Right.
And the further away people get from that, the further away people get from that, that knowledge that it is almost intrinsic in anyone who lives in nature. The harder it is to. Yeah, you know, the more Instagram-worthy quote something is, the harder it is to explain. Well, actually,
but it's not only there because now it's happening at Bulls Bridge. People are going underneath Bulls Bridge, and
they're doing all sorts of foolish things. And I wondered, you know, that Great Falls is so remote, and I said, how do people know about it? And well, dumb me, it's all over the internet. People are told, you know, where to go, how to get there.
Yeah.
They're just publicizing it in certain areas, and people flock there. And bad things can happen.
It's amazing.
And Tom Callahan, who headed up the Pope Property Committee, that's that 59 acres they've bought over near Salmon Kill, was at the meeting. They're going to do a walkthrough on Fall Festival weekend. They're sort of finishing up their work, and they want to get people out there now, bring the public in to get some ideas as to what to do with that land. You know, the town bought it, and has lots of possibilities, but there are also lots of ideas that people have, and they've got to narrow it down and figure out what they want to do.
Build a new town hall, to tear that town hall you have down now and make parking. Bingo.
Well, there's an idea, because they were talking about the lack of parking on Main Street.
I mean, that's it. You know, I mean, you could have put a nice parking lot there and put a proper that town hall is beautiful. Don't get me wrong. It's a beautiful town hall. It's just situated. They tried to redo the old one, and the old one sooner or later would have had been replaced if it wasn't for the fire anyway.
Right.
But yeah. You know, put a town hall there and open up some parking for the merchants there in Salisbury.
There's parking issues all over. In Canaan, they're banning parking along Prospect Street, that narrow street that goes between West Main and Bragg. And there's just, you know, these roads were not built for cars on both sides and plow trucks and fire trucks. And so parking, you wouldn't think in these small towns is an issue, but it is. And so is speeding. I've heard that now in several towns. Yeah. They're having more and more accidents with people just speeding.
It's true. No comment except that, and people who are listening, unfortunately, aren't necessarily the people who need to hear this.
Mm-hmm.
But there needs to be a whole bunch more respect. That's all.
Oh, it's awful. It's terrible. It's interesting. Gordon Ridgway said, I think in the month of July, there were like 12 accidents in Cornwall, which is ridiculous. People, especially going up Route 4, up to Goshen, it's just crazy. Speaking of Cornwall, there's talk of a new business coming to where the Wandering Moose used to be. Gordon Ridgway talked about it at the selectmen's meeting. He didn't reveal who's coming and what's coming, but the talk about town is that it's going to be an electric bike store. So that will be interesting to see and watch.
All right.
As for the coming week, we've got the doubleheader tonight in Falls Village, Board of Finance and Board of Selectmen, and that's it. I have nothing on my calendar.
No, look, for tonight, other than the Park and Recreation Commission in both Cornwall and in Kent meeting for tonight, there's not much more going on.
Yeah, it's really, we're talking the doldrums of August here. Yeah. And anything going on next weekend, Marshall?
Nothing super, super, super
no,
big.
I'm surprised. But the following week, the new teachers do start on Monday, the 19th. So,
I can tell you that the Canaan Fire Company is holding a golf tournament on September 16th, and they are looking for sponsors and teams.
Ah.
So if people are interested, 860-601-3130.
Very good. Okay.
Ruth.
Okay. Well, have a good week, guys.
And we will
onward
speak
and upward.
We'll
good
speak
luck
to you
out
next
there.
Monday.
Very good. Take care, guys.
Bye-bye. Ruth Epstein from the Republican American here on Robin Hood Radio. You can find Ruth's story at rep-am.com and also in the newspaper.